Hey guys, it's Kelsey, and I'm going to be doing my Dragon Slayer review today. I completed the quest yesterday and made my guide. It's on my channel. I worked really hard. The quest took me about 6 hours without a guide, and the guide itself, creating it, took about 6 hours worth of editing, so please check that out. Now I'm going to do the review because, in all honesty, I did a complaint video on some things that I really didn't like Jagex doing. They were pushing the quest too soon, and I still do believe that. Dragon Slayer 2 kind of took away the nostalgia from Dragon Slayer, and all these kind of things. However, I do want to say Jagex did a great job, and they proved me wrong in a lot of ways. I'm going to start with the positive and then go to the complaints, because I believe that overall, this quest was a 7 out of 10. Monkey Madness, probably 8.5 to 9 out of 10. Probably 9 out of 10. I would even push Monkey Madness 2 to 10 out of 10. They did a phenomenal job. This was good. It was too short to be a Grandmaster quest. The difficulty, on par. The only thing in difficulty that they lacked was were the mazes. The mazes were too simple. And so I do have to complain about that. Basically, you had to get 4 pieces to a key, and those were pretty easy to get. The only one that was difficult was Vograth. I hope I pronounced that right. And he wasn't even that hard. I killed him on the first attempt. And the mazes were extremely simple, and the puzzles were. They could have gone a little bit harder for Grandmaster, especially since I was able to complete those without a guide. But other than that, the style was done great. They really did a great job on keeping the integrity of Dragon Slayer 1 and incorporating that same kind of vibe and storyline into Dragon Slayer 2. Great job. And they made it with the Dragonkin, and the story and the cutscenes were all phenomenal. It felt like old school RuneScape. And they did that with Monkey Madness 2. And I really applaud Jagex for doing that. And that is simply why I'm okay with Dragon Slayer 2 being incorporated in the game. Phenomenal job, Jagex. Kudos to you. 7 out of 10. You didn't hit quite on the par of Monkey Madness 2, but you did good. I both have completed Monkey Madness 2 and Dragon Slayer 2 without a guide and with friends only. And so I'm comparing them to both of them on the day of release. Monkey Madness 2 took me significantly longer than Dragon Slayer 2 because of the docks, and the bosses were also harder, like Kruk, an example. And the mazes were much harder too, getting to Kruk. That was a struggle. But I truly think that the whole storyline was fantastic. Another thing I really want to point out is that the rewards, pretty good. They've pretty much settled on the accumulator, which was great. I agreed with that. Dragon Plate Body and all that, agreed. It was good. Overall, that's very good. We needed it in the game. I'm not sure if they went with the Dragon Kite Shield. There's some things that I haven't looked up, but we'll find out very soon. I can't use the Grand Exchange to find out. Let me see. Dragon Kite Shield. They did incorporate the Dragon Kite Shield. To be honest with you, I think they should have waited to incorporate that at a later date, but that's fine. It's not a big deal. Another thing is, what else did they do that was really good? Like I said, I would just say the vibe and storyline of this quest was phenomenal. Kudos to that. I really appreciate how they did that. And great job, Jagex. You proved me wrong in a lot of the things. I'm not too happy with all the rewards. Pretty much, I'm going to go to the negatives now. The rewards, they did this super anti-fire thing where you basically don't need a dragon fire shield or an anti-fire shield at all. I believe that is fire. It's some kind of very super anti-fire. I completely disagree with that, and they really only did that for the purpose of Vograth because people were able to blowpipe it and not have to use a dragon fire shield or a dragon anti-fire thing. They didn't have to do that anymore, which is great. Some people really like that, but they seem to do the purpose for that for only one boss. And the problem is now it's made all the other dragon bosses like KBD so easy, ridiculously easy. And it's taken away, I'm going to say this word again, the integrity of older RuneScape bosses Which you don't want those bosses to become too easy. They're still a boss. I don't know. I completely disagreed with that, and I said no, and it still passed, and some people are going to love that. Great. If you love it, that's all that matters. I don't think that that needed to be implemented in the game. It's making it a little bit too easy, like RS3. Actually, very much too easy, and really, they did it because of the new boss, Vokarath. And I'm pretty sure I'm still pronouncing that wrong, but that's fine. Final boss, another complaint, is that the artwork was minimal. It was just like, I love that it was a serpent, and it's the only serpent flying dragon thing in the game. That's great, because this mix between Dragonkin and the dragons. Fantastic. It was too small. I don't know if they didn't have been able to put it in the code to make it bigger, or what the problem is. With Java programming, you should be able to do anything. And I know that because I've taken Java programming myself. However, if they could have put some wings on it, or kept it a serpent and just made it bigger, scarier, it was really cool looking, but it looks like a Pokemon, and like Yu-Gi-Oh, and all of these things that it was like copied. And I really like how RuneScape, like Abyssal Sire, and so many things are so unique. I understand that you can't get too unique with a dragon, but when you start copying off of other people's work, I would have kept it a big scary dragon that was like red or something. Red and orange, could have been a serpent, looked like a Chinese dragon. Keep it original, but don't copy people's work. Get it bigger. It was too small. The boss fight, though, incredible. The boss fight was amazing. Perfect difficulty. I felt scared. I died a lot from getting one-hitted because the boss fight could one-hit you. The mechanics, I'm tired of Jagex using the same mechanics over and over again. I want something spicy, but I understand that you can't really do much more. And it was already a pretty difficult fight. So, I mean, kudos to them. More mechanics in the future would be awesome, but you can only do so much. Overall, that was my review on Dragon Slayer 2. What I'm really happy about is that they did not come out with the Dragon Crossbow because we already have the Dragon Hunter Crossbow. Great, I'm glad they didn't come out with that. That would have been bad doo-doo. So overall, my complaints and are only about 30 or 40% compared to the 60% of compliments. And so 7 out of 10. Good job, Jagex. And I want to know y'all's thoughts on Dragon Slayer 2. What do you really like and what do you really dislike? And overall, what would you rate this quest? After all, this is only my opinion. Thanks for watching.